I want to talk to you about how we try to put ICH at the heart of the museum policy. I have to go back to 2012, and then we were the Heritage Unit, and you saw this already this morning. I think I have to give Gorcha to come in. Okay. we looked at it this morning. That was also the point of view I took when they asked us as a heritage unit to try to develop a concept of the city for the City Museum of Mechelen, the Hofvaart Museum. But maybe it's necessary to tell you what is a heritage unit, because it's not everywhere do you have, I think only in Flanders you have heritage units. And it's like a Flemish instrument, but that acts on a regional level, and it's embedded in a regional level. And it doesn't have a collection, but it works like a broker between all kinds of organizations, try to detect needs, try to work with all the heritage organizations and communities on a regional level. So that's a heritage unit. From that point of view, we were trying to make a museum or making a concept for a city museum. So, and then when we read this ICOM definition, for us it was very important in service of the society and its development. And the first thing we asked, if you are a heritage unit, is do you need a museum to do so? So why do we need the museum? And if you talk about social impact and you talk about a museum of the city, then you have this question, who is it for? So that was the starting questions when we tried to develop a concept for the museum in 2012. And then we came to a quote which I always use, and it's a quote by Walter Benjamin. Every image of the past that is not recognized by the present as one of its own concerns threatens to disappear irretrievably. So what does this quote mean? It means that you have always a kind of dynamic process, and giving meaning and make it socially relevant is about giving meaning. Now, here I want to talk about, if you change the word image to object, painting, story, tradition, but also museum, you get a point. And you see, and here I think it's very important, or I want to stress this out, that for intangible heritage is mostly connected to the idea of a dynamic process. But museum is mostly connected to the idea of being static, and so on, and museum too. Now, I would argue that if you want to be relevant as a museum, that your process about objects and about museums should be dynamic. So I would like to question that. Now, if you think about the City Museum, and it's about the city, then who are the stakeholders of a City Museum? And then you see that there are a lot of stakeholders in a city museum. It's not only the heritage organizations and communities, it's also the politics, the tourism, the academics, the education, welfare, inhabitants, midfield organizations, and etc. So, if I read a position paper and they put in the economic and touristic approach as a kind of possibility to be capsuled in, then I say if you wanted to make a vision for your museum, you have to take into account all these kind of stakeholders and try to develop a holistic vision where you get this multi-layered way of looking at giving meaning to this city museum. Also, if it means that your aim of your city museum changes. So that's what happened. So stakeholders defined the outcome of the museum. And so we didn't go for a city museum. We had a kind of hybrid form of a museum, which we had a thematic museum of the Burgundian period. But this theme was mixed with the city, so you had a city museum. And we were trying to develop this in a participatory way. So these three parts are taken into account and took us to build the concept of this museum. Okay. Now, if you look at, because I didn't talk about ICH yet, so if you look at this museum, where you have this participatory, I told you have this Burgundian team, you have this city team, how can you put in ICH? How can you interweave it in your museum policy? And we put on different levels, ICH throughout the museum setting, ICH in the objectives, and also linked, these objectives are not one-on-one linked with functions of a museum, but they are linked. ICH in the day-to-day operations of the museum, and ICH at the heart of the organizational development. Okay, I'm gonna skip this because otherwise it will take me too long. So I give some examples on how we do it. So here you see one of the museum rooms. It's at the end of the public and network spaces. You have this museum room where we give communities or somebody as a human living treasure the possibility to fill in a room. Every year we change the organizations or the people who built this room with us. And they will always have a place on the ceiling, so there will be something mounted on the ceiling, so they will keep, it will keep growing. But the importance here is that you, with your organizations or with your communities, build a museum room. And for instance, here it's the dragons are from a famous Mechelen puppeteer, Alcotran. And what you can't see, but what you will see if you go to the museum this evening, there's also a platform where you can do lace bobbing and try and find out how to make it. So, next. I will skip this because it's take too long. Then incorporate in the primary strategic objective of the museum. Is a project that is called De Grond der Dingen, the foundation of things, but it also means the soil. And with this project we gave every inhabitant of the city 1 square meter of ground, and we got 20,000 square meters of the city. And now we're going to decide, with all those people together, what we will do on these 20,000 square meters. Now, what does this have to do with ICH? First of all, I think we will try to think together about democracy, and I think the idea of democracy can be like it's a tradition that we live through by living it and reflecting on it and so on. And the idea of the commons. How can we create commons again? So this is the idea of this ICH practice, where we also try to have a lot of attention for the opponent voices. And we use, like, for instance, deep democracy to get all the voices together. So, also incorporated in the museum functions. This you won't see yet in the museum because it's due to be here in June. It will be installed in the museum. And it's a project with Claudia Onsa, who you see here. And she's a Dutch textile artist. And we will try to remake the process of 16th century of making black. And we will try to do that with the artists, but also with the people who visit the museum. And we will use this outcome of the sensation of making, the process of making and transmitting of the process. Will it be helpful to have a better insight in the color black? And we will use that data for research. And that's Artechne, it's a research group of Utrecht. And they will use this data to create research. Right. Then, incorporated to day-to-day operations. Here you can see a perfect example of how this brokerage thing works. You have a city and you have two traditions. You have one on the giant barriers, the giant tradition, and you have one on the banging sound tradition, Sint Maarten, where Sint Maarten, should I say, in Mechelen, where children sing a song and get candy or money. And so we put them together, and together they realize a lot of more impact. Another of these day-to-day practitioners is, for instance, this Heritage Day. We try to revive the posh coffee drinking competition. It was a competition that was held in neighborhoods in the 30s, 40s, and so they dressed up and drank coffee and gave points to each other. And we tried to revive this competition in Heritage Day. So, organizational development. Now here, if you think about museums, and you have all these kind of ways of putting in or working with ICH, if you think about museums, what is very, very important for museums is their collection. Often all starts from their collection. So if you want to put ICH in the heart of the museum, you should also try to implement ICH in the collection plan. And I think it's a project we go with B and Fano and also ICO. So a lot of partners already are in this place for this experiment. An experiment where we will try to make a collection planning where ICH is really integrated in the collection planning. Now, that doesn't mean we want to freeze the ICH. We want to have to try to find ways in how we can go about collecting living expressions of culture, how to decide on which expressions to collect. If you see the variety already in our museum of possibilities, you can see that we shall have to make choices, and if you have the city as a playground, it will be immensely. How to move forward to planning in a participatory way, because we have to be participatory all the way if we want to be participatory, otherwise it won't be of the use again. And questions as what to collect, safeguard with regards to ICH-related objects. Do we collect the traces? Do we collect current practices, and how do you collect it? A lot of questions. Now, if you think about your organization and ICE, I think it's necessary to keep it in a balanced way in your organization. And this is the model of Queen. I use it to try to define if we have all kinds of balances in our organization. And then you see human relations model. And if you heard the story about the giants and begging some connection, it's really this brokerage role that's in place there. So it's a human relation model. If you think about putting the ICH in the objectives, it's a way to have it in an internal process model. if you think about the Back to Black and the experiment that we are trying to use ICH or ICH to be used for research, then you are in an innovative model. And if you look at how we put ICH in collection planning, it's of course a rational goal model because we want to go for goals. So, conclusion. Okay, it's the last one, sorry. The benefits of the heritage unit model, brokerage, and important method, I think, is one of the points that I want to point out if you want to go for ICH. Now, I didn't reflect on it because there was not much time, but the opportunities of the Flemish heritage policies, here you see that with the decree of 2017, we have the possibility to go for the integrated vision on four museums with ICH. But that doesn't mean necessarily that everybody does, but it is a possibility. The interest of a multiplicity of communities and stakeholders should be taken into account. It's for us necessary to take into account also the touristic, the economic, the academic, all these different kinds of perspective views. Interwoven in a multi-layer perspective of the museum and its museum functions. I think it's clear. And we want to see it as a multiplicity of stakeholders. It's an ongoing process. As well, the ICH at your museum is an ongoing process. And ICH at the heart of the museum and organization to integration into the collection plan, I just told you about. I think it's important to have really balanced it in your organizational development method. And it's progressive insight and experiment. That's what I would like to add, because I think it's an ongoing process, and I think that's the end of my right. So that's a statement.